What's the deal with this one?
Man, I've had it for a while. I just don't have time to mess with it and no room, really. But I'd sell you this one. It's original paint, 65.
Really?
And you look at it, there's no rust.
I love the color on it.
Yeah, I did. Man, honestly, I think that stuff would just buff right out.
Man, I think this thing looks sexy buffed. I really like it.
So it's down some.
What year did you say this is?
65.
65?
Yeah.
So just all bone stock?
Yeah, just bone stock. Stock 40 horse, original paint, good pans, good heater channels.
Smells a little musty.
They all do.
Find one that don't.
I need something like this, is probably what we need. So it's real straight. I just see one whiskey dent on that corner over there.
Yeah, I think you just did that, didn't you?
That'd be a beer dent. I was thinking more like $4,500.
Nah, I can't do that. Richard, I know you're a Wheeler dealer, but I've been doing this a while. You're not getting it for $4,500.
You know, it's crazy. I have no idea if he's low or you're high. I don't know what it is. I want to think this is a $500 car, but I'm sure that's wrong.
15 years ago, it was a $500 car. These things are getting hard to find. Original paint, original stickers, unmessed with. You can ask Aaron.
All right, how about $5,500?
Man, it's still a little bit low.
Well, listen, we could offset a little bit. Y'all build some Volkswagen parts, don't you?
We do.
We're going to need Volkswagen parts if we build it, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Say if we can get closer to his price, maybe he can hook us up with a bunch of parts we need.
I'll do this. $6,000, we'll build you a 4-inch narrowed beam, get it on the ground. We'll build you some drop plates in the back to get it sitting right. If you got questions, you got issues, we'll help you out with the motors and stuff like that. And $6,000, I think we can get it done.
Does that work?
I have no idea what these are worth.
All right, man, we'll do it. Treat us right on the little van, so let's see what we can do with this.
I really like this little 65, and I want to do it upright, so here's the plan. We're going to stick it to the ground with a suspension package from Air-Cooled Custom VW. Then replace the stock wheels and tires with two-piece 17s front and back.
It wouldn't take much to get the VW engine running, but with 40 horsepower it puts out, it just won't make it for us. So we'll turn to Elliot again for a motor making about five times that.
And Coy gets a break because I'll bring in a guy to fix the whiskey dents and buff out the original paint.
I'm setting the deadline at just 2 weeks because Aaron booked himself a little time off. So for once, I can bank on him getting this build done in time.
Okay, go for it. Yep, you got it. Speed okay, we'll hold on.
We're gonna put a new suspension, new engine, new interior, but keep that old look of the car.
Easy peasy, huh?
You'll be able to hop in it, man, and haul ass.
TFT knows his VWs, man. Tony Taylor Tool Time, go for it.
Now we're just taking the rear suspension, transmission, front suspension, getting everything out of the way so we can add all the new fun stuff.
Oh, you're done.
Good enough.
Between you and Charles, the knowledge of Volkswagens,
I got dirty.
We got the front suspension in for the bug, and it looks cool. Everything is pre-built. We just need to get it hung on the car.
If I get it high enough.
Good. One air-cooled front end installed. You good to go.
It's nice to pick up a rear end section that's that light.
Installing this transaxle is just about as easy. Compared to all the other cars and trucks we do, this transaxle weighs nothing at all. I think when we get done with this, this bug is really gonna be badass. It'll be super quick with 5 times the power from the new motor.
Yeah, you wanna get that lift.
I gotcha. You want to let it sit on that one?
You can just leave it on that one.
All right, go ahead.
We kind of anticipated it because of the width of the motor. So we pulled the valve covers off. Ended up having just enough room to get it squeezed in there.
We're inside down. Oh. How are you on the other side?
Hang on.
You're good. You're clear on the back.
Go down. Oh. Okay, hold on.
Hold it. Yeah, we're on them now.
It fit. I mean, once we got it hung on the bottom two bolts, I just shoved it on there.
Got it.
Jason started the hardware on there. Boom.
The dishes are done, dude.
Nothing easier than putting a motor in a bug, I can tell you that.
The Beetle's level of completeness is, oddly enough, very close to being complete. We're short in upholstery, which is a drop kick and a couple bolts away.
That's a rear right there.
So the Beetle's rapidly approaching being complete.
Really anxious to see how this thing sits.
Oh, tell me about it.
But we're about to put the wheels and tires on. I'm really curious to see how it sits.
Initially, the plan for this car was to build just a proper Beetle, straight up. And so far, I'm really, really happy with the way everything's come together, from tailpipes to headlights. I think that we have a proper Beetle. It's got all the right parts. Everything's super nice. And I think it's gonna be a great driver.
I like that subtle color difference.
It's supposed to match whatever's in the interior.
Okay. Oh, really?
It's supposed to be one of the colors of the interior.
Gotcha.
Contact. The back might be a little high.
Might be a little tall.
Not as low as I want it. Obviously, these are adjustments that can be made.
No, no.
It sits a little high, but you know what? Today's not the day to adjust all that. We have an upholstery go in, glass has to go in. There's still a lot of things that have to be done, so we're not gonna waste any time with that, but we will ultimately be quite a bit lower. It needs to come down a couple more, I mean, at least three in the back and at least another one in the front. But like I said, it's not a pavement scraper by any means, but we definitely need it to have the right look and the right performance level.
Started off with a 1600cc motor making 40 horsepower, switched it over to the big motor, over 200 horse. This thing, fast.
17-inch rims, brakes all the way around, custom front end to get it down low and mean, rear suspension, you name it. I told the guys in the paint shop that I wanted the wheel centers to match the interior. When they got painted the first time, they were gray. Can you explain that?
You just said match the interior, which we didn't have an interior color to go with, so we just started painting. I painted a color that Jason told me to paint. Then I painted a color that I thought looked good.
I helped
then
you pick
I painted
it out.
A color that you picked out.
So we only did it like four times and we were all wrong.
In the end, we made them body color, and that's not gonna bug anyone. To finish it off, we redid the interior, freshened up the bright work, and added a classic roof rack to add a little old school style. So there you have it, guys and gals, our 1965 Volkswagen Bug. Original paint, killer style, killer power, ready for sale. Give me a call.
What do you think Aaron's doing right now?
It's kind of like seeing your parents naked. You don't want to think about it.
Ugh.
Hey, we'll see y'all back at the shop.
Hey. Oh, yeah. Hey, boy,
just clear. Hey, you know what? Yeah. Last time we crammed into this, no thanks.